being live streamed. Today is Wednesday, the 11th week of Ordinary Time. Please stand for our gathering song.
I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have made a sin in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask us, Mary the Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. God, strength of those who hope in you, graciously hear our pleas, and since without you mortal frailty can do nothing, grant us always the help of your grace, that in following your commands we may please you by our resolve and our deeds. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. You may be seated.
A reading from the second book of Kings. When the Lord was about to take Elijah up to heaven in a whirlwind, he and Elisha were on the way from Gilgal. Elijah said to Elisha, "Please stay here. The Lord has sent me on to the Jordan." As the Lord lives, and as you yourself live, I will not leave you, Elisha replied. And so the two went on together. 50 of the guild prophets followed, and when the two stopped at the Jordan, they stood facing them at a distance. Elijah took his mantle and rolled it out, and struck the water, which divided, and both crossed over on dry land. When they had crossed over, Elijah said to Elisha, ask for whatever I may do for you before I am taken from you. Elisha answered, may I receive a double portion of your spirit? You have asked something that is not easy, Elijah replied. Still, if you see me taken up from you, your wish will be granted. Otherwise, not. As they walked on conversing, a flaming chariot and flaming horses came between them. And Elijah went up to him in a whirlwind. When Elisha saw it happen, he cried out, my father, my father, Israel's chariots and drivers. But when he could no longer see him, Elisha gripped his own garment and tore it in two. Then he picked up Elijah's mantle that had fallen from him and went back and stood at the bank of the Jordan. Wielding the mantle that had fallen from Elijah, Elisha struck the water in his turn and said, where is the Lord, the God of Elijah? When Elisha struck the water, it divided, and he crossed over. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus said to his disciples, "Take care not to perform righteous deeds in order that people may see them. Otherwise, you will have no recompense from your heavenly Father. When you give alms, do not blow a trumpet before you, as the hypocrites do in the synagogue and in the streets, to win the praise of others. Amen, I say to you, they have received their reward. But when you give alms, do not let your left hand know what your right hand is doing, so that your almsgiving may be secret. And your Father who sees in secret will repay you. When you pray, do not be like the hypocrites, who love to stand and pray in the synagogue and on street corners, so that others may see them. Amen, I say to you, they have received their reward. But when you pray, go to your inner room, close the door, and pray to your Father in secret, and your Father who sees in secret will repay you. When you fast, do not look gloomy like the hypocrites. They neglect their appearance so that they may appear to others to be fasting. Amen, I say to you, they have received their reward. But when you fast, anoint your head and wash your face, so that you may not appear to others to be fasting, except to your Father who is hidden. And your Father who sees what is hidden will repay you." The Gospel of the Lord.
Good day to everyone once again, and welcome. Welcome to all of you. Welcome to everyone who is joining us via live stream. I am so proud of all of you who will be receiving your first communion today, and I'm so excited for you. And I commend your parents and your family for all the work that they have, all the goodness that they have introduced you to in the life of faith. I commend you, parents and uncles and aunts and grandparents, for all the work that you're doing to impress upon your children the importance of our faith and the importance of this day. I don't know about you all, but I like to eat candy. Candy, in my opinion, tastes good. Do you agree? Sometimes candy is sweet, sometimes candy is sour, but I like to eat candy. And one of my favorite candies is Nerds. You know Nerds? You know Nerds. Those little bits of soury, sweet little pebbles of goodness, crunchy goodness, they're so tasty. You know Nerds, right? Yeah, Nerds. Keep them in my pocket. When I was a kid, my older brother would tease me. And whenever I would eat Nerds, he would tell me, "You are what you eat." And have we heard this phrase before? You are what you eat? If we eat unhealthy foods, we can become unhealthy. But if we eat healthy foods, we can become healthy and be healthy. I have a friend who used to eat so many carrots. He's like a rabbit. He'd eat carrots all the time. And he would drink carrot juice. He ate so many carrots and drank so much carrot juice that his skin started turning orange. For real. And I told him, I said, "Maybe you should lay off the carrots because you're starting to look like one." If only he just dyed his hair green, he would really look like. Many of you here have been preparing for your first Holy Communion. And when we come to Mass, We participate as people who believe in Jesus, the Son of God. We gather together, sitting, sometimes standing, sometimes kneeling, together to give thanks to God for all the goodness in the world and all the goodness in our life. We give thanks to God for our family and for our friends. We give thanks to God for the goodness of our Lord Jesus Christ, who loves us more than we can ever imagine. Jesus loves us, always. He loves us forever. And Jesus wants us to love all people the way He loves all people. Jesus wants us to be like Him, to learn from Him, to be kind to all people, to comfort people, to welcome people, to feed people, to protect people, to teach people to do good things, and to forgive people when they do wrong things. Jesus wants us to be like Him, good and holy. And Jesus gives us Himself to eat and to drink, His body and His blood, the Eucharist, Holy Communion, every time we come to Mass. Of all the things we can do in our life, coming to Mass and being in communion with God and with His people, it's the very best thing. It's the best. I love going to Mass. I love Mass so much, it helped me to hear God's calling me to be a priest. And when we go to Mass, we remember how good Jesus is. When we eat Jesus' body and drink His blood, we become what we eat. We, as God's people, become in a special and mysterious way like Jesus. We start to act more like Jesus. We pray more. We are more kind. We are more generous. We share more. And we thank God more and thank each other more. We love God and each other more and more the more we come to Mass. And just like we eat together with our family at our home, Jesus invites us into His home, the church, to eat as a family with Him at His table. We spend family time with Jesus, eating supper with Him. And we get to know Him better. We get to know each other better by spending time with Jesus and spending time with each other. And Jesus knows this is the best way to spend our time as a family, eating together, giving thanks and praise to our God through Jesus. What looks like bread and wine has been transformed by Jesus into His body and blood. And we learned about this in our classes, didn't we? It really and truly is Jesus in the bread and the wine. Jesus has changed it from bread into His body, and has changed it from wine into His blood. And Jesus does this through the priest. It really is Jesus. Jesus who loves all of us so much. He gives Himself to us totally. And we become what we eat. We become what we drink. We become who we eat and who we drink. We become Jesus, His body, able to show love to God and to our neighbors in a more perfect way. We become one with God and one with each other. And just like all food gives us energy to do things, when we receive communion, we get energy to do good things, Jesus gives us the energy to do good. And just like all foods, we need to eat regularly. We need the energy to do good. So we come to Mass often, so we can have the energy to keep going, to keep following Jesus, to continue learning from him. So for all of you who will be receiving your first Holy Communion today, let this be a reminder. You are what you eat. You are who you eat and who you drink. We believe Jesus when he says to all of us, "Take and eat, this is my body. Take and drink, this is my blood." Do you know how old I was when I got my first communion? I was 29 years old. So all of you are way ahead of me. I expect good things from you. And when we come here, my brothers and sisters, we remember how good Jesus is. We remember how much he loves all of us. God sees all that we do in secret. Let us open our hearts to him in prayer and present our petitions before the throne of grace.
Our response today is, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for the church that she might act as a leaven in society, raising up all things to the Father through his Son. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all Christians, that their love for one another may be from a pure heart and not be trained by hypocrisy. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayers.
We pray for the governments of this world, that their deliberations might be guided by the Spirit of truth for the benefit of all mankind. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayers.
We pray for those who are persecuted because they refuse to compromise with the truth, that the Lord might give them strength in their trials. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayers.
And we pray that we might not live according to the opinions of others, but in conformity with the will of God. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayers.
We pray in a special way for all who will be receiving their first communion today. May they experience an encounter with our Lord in a transformative and peaceful and wonderful way. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
we pray in a special way for all healthcare professionals. May they be safe in their work, and may they be strengthened by the Holy Spirit in their healing touch. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our.
And let us ask for our Blessed Mother's intercession, praying, Hail Mary,
full of grace, the Lord is with thee.
pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. O God, who in the offerings presented here provide for the twofold needs of human nature, nourishing us with food and renewing us with your sacrament, grant, we pray, that the sustenance they provide may not fail us in body or in spirit, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Father most holy, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your Word, through whom you made all things, whom you sent as our Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin. Fulfilling your will and gaining for you a holy people, he stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so, with the angels and all the saints, we declare your glory, as with one voice we acclaim. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity together with Francis, our Pope, and Gustavo, our Archbishop, Michael, our Auxiliary Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord,
fire.
Thank you.
about unity in your church. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
I'd like to say a special thanks to Christian Process and the Faith Formation team for all the work that they've been doing to prepare the children for their First Communion, the sacramental formation. I also say a word of thanks to all the volunteers who served as catechists that have assisted in catechizing the children and preparing them for the life of faith. Thanks to all of you. What a joyous day today, and I pray for all of you that you may experience this day and remember it for the rest of your life. The Lord be with you. May the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit descend upon you and remain with you forever.
Amen. The Mass has ended. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thank you.